Well, hi everyone. Here we are with another animal encounter. Now I have to say that like 35 times while notifications go out till people get on. Here we are with another animal encounter. We're going to do another animal encounter.
Yes, we are.
What are we going to do?
An animal encounter.
We're going to do an animal encounter. Okay, so we're here at, this is the most unique zoo in the entire world. Mm-hmm. That will be true, correct?
Yes, yes.
What other zoo in the world, okay, here's a test for you all. Okay, what other zoo in the world, what other zoo has Noah's Ark behind it? None. There's only one. It's at the Ark Encounter and it's called Ararat Ridge Zoo. So, boys and girls, we recorded this one ahead of time because of the coronavirus situation and we weren't sure what we're going to be allowed to do and not do and all the rest of it. We're streaming it as live. We still want you to put your questions in there. And one of our staff, in fact, it'll probably be Karina over here, we'll go in and answer your questions for you while we're streaming it live. But I have Leanne with us. She's our senior zoo manager. Okay, I've got a question for them, and then you can help them to figure out the answer.
Yes.
Okay. What animal is this? You should know that. Well, some of you might get it wrong, though. What animal is this one that... just be careful, you could get it wrong. It could be a trick question. It's sort of a trick question.
Yes.
So what animal is this? And secondly, what animal kind does it belong to?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So Leanne, you want to help them through this?
Okay. So here we have Japheth. And Japheth is a llama.
Japheth.
Japheth.
That's from the Bible.
Yes.
Okay.
So all of our animals here at the Ark are... they do have biblical names. So we have three llamas. We have Shem, Ham, and Japheth. So they are named after Noah's sons.
You didn't name the one Ham after me?
No.
No. Okay.
No.
All right. So after the Ham in the Bible.
After the Ham in the Bible, yes.
All right.
So Japheth here is a llama. Some features that distinguish a llama from maybe another animal that we have in here that looks very similar, that is very easy to get confused with a llama, is an alpaca. So we also have two alpacas in here. We have Cain and Abel. They're kind of hanging out there in the background.
Cain and Abel. I wouldn't want to be Abel.
Yeah.
Has Cain never been seen to attack Abel and try to kill Abel?
No, they get along very well.
Okay.
So a lot of people get confused of the difference between a llama and an alpaca or think that they're interchangeable terms, but they are two different species, but they are members of the same created kind.
Okay, so is it a llama alpaca kind or is it bigger than that?
Well, stand by.
Oh,
we're gonna see something else
myself,
that is also part of
were there
the
two
same
llamas
kind.
On the ark? Were there two alpacas on the ark?
Stay tuned.
Probably not.
Probably not.
We're gonna find out. Okay.
Okay. So llamas and alpacas are both what we call New World camelids. So what that means is both of them are found in the New World. Thank you, Leah.
Okay.
We're gonna let her finish.
This is
real
fun.
Quick. This is great.
Okay, that's the horse kind. We
that's
dealt with
kind.
The horse kind in a previous one.
We already did that.
You know what? He's jealous.
Yeah,
he wants the camera on him. All right.
Okay.
Anyway, that was fun. Wasn't that fun? Okay. All right. That was the horse kind. That was the donkey.
That was a donkey over there.
Okay.
So.
Right.
Japheth is part of this kind, and he is called a New World camelid. So New World camelids are found in the New World.
What was that word?
Camelid.
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 How do you spell that?
C-A-M-E-L-I-D.
I'm starting to get a hint as to what kind these belong to. You're getting a hint? It's a camelid. There's
camelid.
A hint. Okay, keep going.
So llamas and alpacas are members of this New World camelids, which means they are found just in the New World. So they're found in South America, and they're found in mountains of Peru. And these guys are perfectly designed for the habitat in which they live. So if you notice, they've got these nice, fuzzy, thick coats. We'll see if Japheth lets me show you guys how thick his coat is. So if I stick my hands down in his coat, it is nice and thick and warm. So, as I said, llamas and alpacas kind of get confused. But the easiest way to tell the llamas and alpacas apart is their size. So if you notice, Japheth here is quite tall. I'm standing next to Karina. You can see how tall he is. He is taller than she is.
Well, I'm 6 foot. Let me stand beside Karina here. So how am I up to his ears yet? Top of his ears?
Yeah, you're
getting close.
You're getting close. Okay. You're getting close. All right. So the biggest difference between llamas and alpacas is their size. Alpacas are quite a bit smaller than the llama. They're about usually about 36 inches at their shoulder, where the llamas can be anywhere from usually about 4 feet at the shoulder. That's one of the biggest differences, their size. And also, a little hint for boys and girls out there is if you look at their ears, you can tell right away if they're a llama or an alpaca. So llamas, if Japheth will look over here for us, has banana-shaped ears. So he's got these really, really long ears that kind of curve inward, kind of like a banana. Whereas the alpaca has shorter ears that are much straighter and they don't curve in nearly as much.
We could call him banana head. No, that wouldn't be good.
No, that wouldn't be nice.
Okay, all right. I got into trouble from our zoo manager. Okay, so one question, Leanne. When I look at this fur here, do they, you know, we shear sheep and use the wool. Do they do the same with alpacas?
Yes. So we shear our alpacas. We also shear our llamas as well. But the alpacas have really thick, soft hair that is actually hypoallergenic. So a lot of sheep's wool has lanolin in it. And some people are allergic to that lanolin. Well, the alpaca fiber does not have lanolin in it. So if you're allergic to the lanolin in sheep's wool, you may be able to wear an alpaca fiber.
Oh, I'll be. I didn't know that.
And we have something really special here. We actually have, there's two different hair types or fiber types on alpacas, and we actually have a representation of both those fiber types. We have a Suri and we have a Huayaca, who is down there along the fence. The Suri up here, he is quite rare. We're very, very fortunate to have him. He's got kind of, it almost looks like long, silky hair. There's not many that have this type of fiber, so we're very fortunate to have him here. And these guys do get sheared once a year.
Now, you say guys, so are they guys or girls or both, or what are they?
So we have five males here. They're all boys. They are neutered, so they're called geldings.
So I presume the reason you have males is because males are the best behaved, obviously. I mean, is that true?
So these guys all came to us from a variety of sources.
She didn't answer yes or no. Did you hear that? She's trying to be, yeah, okay, go on.
These guys came to us from several different facilities. We ended up getting all males.
And is it true, Karina, that this alpaca just loves you?
This is a llama.
Oh, see, I got it wrong. Did you correct me? That's right, the banana ears. I got to look at the banana ears.
He's a llama.
Okay.
And I've known Japheth for probably 4 years now, close to 4 years. Mm-hmm. So we do have a relationship.
Yeah. Here, I'll steal that to answer Ken's question. So, yes, I've known, hello, hi. I have known Japheth now for close to 4 years. So we do have a relationship. So he's probably definitely my favorite llama that we have. He's got a huge personality.
So are you going to kiss him on the nose? Oh, she's actually going to do it? Oh, yuck. Okay, I have some Clorox wipes in my pocket that I use for wiping my microphone. Okay, I think we need to wipe your nose. All right. So, okay, we're going to do something right now. We're going to go over and see the llama and the alpacas to see their relative. Right?
Yes.
Same kind. It's going to be a little bit of a walk. We're going to walk through the zoo. We'll tell you about what we're doing over here, what construction that's going on.
Yes.
You're going to go into the keeper's barn where the public are not allowed to go.
Yes.
Okay.
You're going to go behind the house access.
Where only the zoo staff are allowed to go. We're going to take you in there. This is special, seeing as the Creation Museum and the Ark are closed to the public right now. We're going to take you into the keeper's barn. And as we walk past here, what's this construction going on here?
So, as I said, when I talked a little bit about New World camelids, this is going to be our camelid kind exhibit. So we'll be adding these guys, the llamas and alpacas, back over here. And then the other member of that family, we're going to be adding another member of that family in here as well, who is currently at the Creation Museum.
Okay, so we're swapping some animals around. We're going to really make some changes here ready for when we reopen, as soon as the government allows us to, which is stressing us all out. So
just a little bit.
Just a little bit. And you guys have to come in here every day regardless, and during the night. And you have 200 animals to look after.
Yes, between our, between the Ark and Creation Museum zoo collections, we have about 200 animals.
So as we turn the corner here, we'll get our videographer to turn around and you'll be able to see the Ark. There it is. And there's another one of our zoo staff. And I can see the Ark there. And that's our new animal actor stage area,
yes,
that we'll be using every day, yes, once we're open, for live animal programs.
Yes, we are gearing up. Karina's written a lot of great content. And we have a lot of great show themes planned.
And then as we walk past this area, also over on the right, what's that? There's a new building that's under construction. There's also, what's going to go in this area here too,
behind the green fence? So this area here behind the green fence, that is going to be our bear, cat, and porcupine building and exhibit.
And then the building under construction behind that?
That is the lemur building.
There's a lemur building.
So that's where our ringtail lemurs.
I can see the ostriches over there too.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Alrighty, so let's go. We're going to go into the camel barn. The keeper's barn.
Yes.
Actually,
well, this is the camel barn.
You call it the camel barn. So we're going to go in here where public are not allowed to go, but we're allowed to take you in there, okay?
Yep.
So we're going to take you in there, and we're going to find the llamas and the alpacas cousin,
yes,
relative, maybe second cousin. I don't know. Here we go. So we're inside the camel barn,
yep,
here. And what do we normally have in here?
So we had one of our steers and our spotted donkeys in here, but since we moved out our yaks out in the back, they have actually gone out where the yaks were.
Right now, yes. Mm-hmm. And what do we have in here? I hear this noise.
This is Amos. He is one of our Cooney Cooney pigs. So he is in here for some medical treatment. He's got a little bit of a couple little boo-boos that he needs treated every day. So he's separated from his
When you
his
need to
right
isolate
now.
Animals, you bring them in here. This is especially,
yes,
for
usually
looking after them.
If we have some hoof stock, so a lot of our larger animals that have a hoof, we'll bring them over here to do any sort of quarantine or things like that.
Oh,
with
okay,
them.
Excellent. So the pig. What should I call him? Instead of pig, that sort of sounds, you know.
Well, he's a Cooney Cooney pig.
He's a Cooney Cooney pig.
Yes.
Okay, peccary? Peccary kind?
They are in the pig kind.
Yeah,
yes.
In the,
yeah,
pig kind? Okay, so he's not the relative of the llamas.
No, he is not. He is not related,
oh,
to the llama.
Oh, here's the relative.
Here's
can't
the
you
relative.
See, can't you see the similarities?
Yeah. If you look at these guys, you can see there's some similarities to the camel as you look at them. They both have this split upper lip that they use to they can even take individual leaves off of tree branches with these little split lips.
When you look, it you know, yuck. It does look the same as the llamas, mm-hmm, doesn't it?
And then if you look down at his feet as well, I don't know if you guys noticed the llama feet when we were over there, but they both have these two toes with a nail on the front, and then they have basically a big pad. Their foot is a big pad. It's not a hoof like a lot of like horses or cows or even pigs. It's actually, they have a foot that has a pad on it.
Oh, look, there's another one.
There's another one.
Now, are these single hump camels?
Yes. So we have dromedary camels, or the one hump camel here at the Ark Encounter. So we currently have four camels down here. We have Bo, who is our honorary camel here today. And then we have Archie, who's over there in his stall. And then we also have CJ and Luke, who are out in the yard.
Oh, so we have a number of camels here.
Yes.
And we do camel rides.
We do camel rides.
In fact, I wonder if we could just see out the back.
Yeah.
Just at where we do the camel rides.
You can see our camel ride saddle,
yeah,
our saddles over here.
Real quickly. And so all the camel rides from now,
yep,
on are going to be at the Ark.
Yes,
right?
All the camel rides from now on are going to be down here at the Ark.
That's one of the changes we're making. So that's the platform where they hop on.
Yes,
and
so we load kids or people who want to ride the camel. Anybody can ride the camel. You don't have to be a kid to ride the camel. But we'll load them here, and then we do a figure eight around this track out here.
Okay, so let me ask you, see who can guess this. I've got a question for you. How do we know this is the most unique camel ride in the entire world? Have a guess. Yeah, do you think they'll guess it? The most unique camel ride in the world.
Yeah.
There is no other camel ride place just like this, because as you're riding the camel, you're looking at
the Ark.
The Ark.
And it's great. So when you get to the end of your camel ride, we actually stop the camel so that you can get a picture with the ark in the background. Where else can you get a picture on a camel with the ark in the background?
Where else can you get a picture of you on a camel with the ark in the background? Okay, now you see why you have to pray that God will work in the hearts of people in America and this whole situation and in dealing with the all the problems we've got from this coronavirus scare and so on, to get the museum open and the ark open as soon as we can. And just as we come back, look, the camel here wanted you to know that you can get 20% off anything you order online from Answers in Genesis while the ark and the Creation Museum are closed to the public, and you just use Matthew 6 as your code. And a couple of DVDs here. Buddy Davis, who's our dinosaur sculptor and singer and does workshops and does concerts at the Creation Museum, he does these DVDs that are like, you know, they're like reality DVDs with Buddy Davis. And one is when he digs dinosaurs, and the other is going to Alaska. Absolutely incredible. And Buddy also has another book that you see back there, which is great for kids as he has fun talking about animals and so on. And don't forget our Facebook Live programs, 10 a.m., a science experiment, 12 p.m., a presentation by Speaker, I'm getting attacked by a camel. Help, help, I'm being attacked by a camel. Then 3 o'clock, our animal encounter. And then 7 p.m., we're going to do some behind-the-scenes stuff.
He just wants to give you a kiss, Ken.
Yeah, I'm not giving that a kiss. There's no way I'm giving. No, go away. No. Okay. So hope you enjoyed the program today, and we'll have another one for you tomorrow.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, it depends. If this is Friday, it will be Monday.
Yeah.
So it depends on what day. Yeah. Of course. Okay.